بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما. Dear students, this is Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, your course instructor in course standard setting in assessment. Dear students, this is my 15th lecture, unit number 4, your course outline. The topic of the session is scheduling standard setting activities. Standard setting is an integral part of larger enterprise. A careful planning, coordination and communication to complete the process of standard setting successfully. Dear student, this is an overall plan. In the different methods like ENGOF, body of work, bookmark, an agenda, training procedure, analysis procedure, it should be appropriate to the content and format of the test. The nature of standards to be set. It means the plan should be according to the nature of the content, nature of the work activities, and nature of the appropriate methods of standard setting. It may be different for different methods. Dear students, when we start the process of standard setting, the organization which is responsible for making standard setting make a TAC, technical advisory committee. Then schedule assessment programs, employ a panel of nationally recognized experts, and make a policy and practical matters, and review and approve of standard setting method. This is a central focus of this plan. The other parts of the plan, which may includes the other groups, stakeholders are individuals and group with the particular interests, may be elected or appointed officially to complete or to process the standard setting process. Or state superintendents in America, commissioners, board members, etc. To oversight the committees, test steering committee, content review committee, sensitivity review committee, examination construction committee, educator organizations, professional associations, parent organizations, business groups, media representatives, and others. These are all part of the standard setting process, and these are also the part of overall schedule of the plan. Another integral part of the scheduling plan is policy of the board or policy of the scheduling entity. in which make the decisions to adopt, modify or reject the cut scores. It means the policy decisions which are made by the organization or district boards about the making a standard setting or in a certain standard setting method. Rules and procedures vary from state to state. All plans approved by the parties. It means all parties mean all participants of the standard setting procedures like state stakeholders, experts, parents association, teachers associations, district superintendents associations and so on. The all parties which include in the process of standard setting procedure. Participants. Dear students, now I will tell the detail of participants. These includes members of the board who may be asked to nominate qualified individuals. The individuals should be representative of the state as possible. In many instances, parents, businessmen and community leaders are also the participant of the standard setting procedure. The other participants include creation of the standard setting panels. Scheduling the standard setting process during arranging or deciding about the participants, the creation of standard setting panels is made or scheduled. This process, the panels is a three-step process. Number one, at first level, they are local superintendents or their nominees. They identify potential panelists in accordance with specifications provided by the state education agency. Local education officials reward to the state education agency are nominated or forwarded from the education agency the names and brief resumes of their candidates. It means when they decide to schedule standard setting panels, at first level they decide about the panels from local level on the recommendation of district superintendents. They were asked to nominate and superintendents identify potential panelists according to the specifications provided by the state agency. Our local education officials forwarded to the state agency the names and brief resumes of their candidates who have to take part in the standard setting procedure. The second step of panelists, the participants, the second step involves notification of the candidates. When asked to notify candidates prior to submitting their names, some local education officials occasionally fail to do so. Thus, primarily as a safeguard and in an effort to convey a consistent message to all candidates, the state education sent an initial letter to all candidates, and from that list the willing candidates have been selected selected as the to work in panels of standard setting methods. Once potential participants return their interest availability forms, and the third step begins, those who are not interested or unavailable are eliminated from the further consideration, but their forms are retained for later references. It means they are eliminated from the current setting standard or current schedule of standard setting procedure, but their data remained in the main list for future considerations. Dear students, now I will discuss the detail of materials which is the part of scheduling standard setting procedure. The detail of this material and the process are documents. Number one, participant. Agenda, description of materials. It includes list of major activities showing start and stop times. Note taking guide. Usually miniature reproductions of PowerPoint slides with lines for notes. Next, security agreement form, building agreement note to secure the contents of the test or other documents. Then it also includes readiness form, interim session evaluation form indicating panelist, understanding of process and readiness to participate in standard setting activities. Expense form, RTADA bills or remuneration bills or forms. It includes form for reimbursement of all participant expenses, not direct billed to agency or contractor. Bookmark forms, on which panelist enters page numbers for each performance level by round. It means according to the each round the performance levels enter page numbers for each performance level in each round. The next is evaluation form. Forms used by the panelist to evaluate process. Dear student, then final preparation is made. Standard setting is almost always a high profile activity. It is very serious and high profile activities because it the future activity is based on this activity. Everyone involved needs to be thoroughly prepared, so it is ensured during the scheduling process that everyone is thoroughly prepared for this process. All presentations including method specification training should be scripted and rehearsed. All rating forms should be double checked and printed in sufficient quantities to complete the activities with extra material on hand to accommodate unforeseen circumstances. all participant material should be produced, duplicated, collated and assembled into easily used sets. For example, material should appear in packets in the order in which they are to be used or referred to. It means this all material is put in the packets, are usable or in relevant packets or bundles, so that the panelist or standard setting experts can use easily this material without creating a fuss. So if participants or staff will need special equipment or materials including flip chart, markers, blank overhead transparencies, those materials should be purchased, logged in and prepared for shipment to the standard setting site, where at the place where the standard setting process is going on. So everyone involved in the conduct of the standard setting meetings, these include presenters, facilitators, data entry operators, monitors, etc. And these should be familiar with the final approved plan, which should also be copied and distributed for reference to those involved. As a final part of preparation, the entire standard setting staff should conduct a dress rehearsal, making sure that timing of presentations is consistent with the agenda, that all forms are correct and usable, and that the flow of event is logical. Dear students, at the end I will discuss about at the standard setting site and follow up the steps which are taken or which are performed at the standard setting site and which are followed up. It includes the steps and the activities. Number one, facilitators should discuss results among themselves and with representatives of the sponsoring agency, assuming a common method for all facilitators to ensure that they have accurate, consistent understandings of the result before presenting those results to panelists. It means at standard setting site, all activities followed and acted upon strictly according to the schedule, according to the schedule of standard setting. Facilitators should discuss results among themselves and with representatives of sponsoring agency on the assumption a common method for all facilitators. It is ensured that all facilitators are using a common or agreed upon method to ensure that they have accurate, consistent understanding of the result before presenting those results to panelists. In short, it will be necessary to maintain a single voice throughout the session. Single voice mean agreed upon discussion and same discussion throughout the session in order to maintain the confidence of panelists, because if there is a different voices or there is hodgepodge in this process, the panelist may shatter their trust or confidence. So it is necessary to maintain a single voice throughout the session to maintain the confidence of the panelist. Dear students, this was the scheduling standard setting for making standard setting methods or for making standard settings. It is very integral part of the this process, and in other session I will discuss some other topic. Thanks for your interest. Allah Hafiz.